Have you ever had an itch? You knew where it was, but you didn't know exactly if you should put your arm down here or if you should reach it up here? Well, for me, that itch was an open world military game. I wanted the feeling of being in an environment that was hostile against me, that I had to slowly trudge through towards my objective. I wanted to have to change gear depending on what mission I was doing, whether it be in a desert, in a forest, what have you. I wanted the feeling of knowing I was outnumbered. I am the prey in the predator's world, this world that's looming all around me, sneaking or running towards my objective, spending even more of my time steadying tirelessly the enemies until I finally knew exactly my approach. Then I want to perfectly go and execute my approach. And if it doesn't go according to plan, the mission isn't gonna fail. The mission's now gonna go into assault mode. And now I need to go loud. I need to improvise based off the intel I learned to make the best of the situation and try to complete the mission without dying. Over the past year, this itch has gotten progressively worse. So when the Steam Summer Sale rolled around, I knew it was about time to do something about it. Whoa, is that Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon Wildlands? And it's typically $49.99 and you're gonna give it to me for $16.99? Wow, I think I'll take that deal. Thank you. Now that I had my back scratcher, all I had to do was scratch my back. I then waited 2 months before I even launched the sucker because I was busy messing around with glitches in Hitman 2. Gosh dang, it's hot in here.
It's not every day you get to meet an urban legend in the flesh.
You should tell that to my kid. Maybe he'd listen when I tell him to take the trash out.
Your job is to be a small yet deadly strike team that takes out 5 bad guys who are pawns of a bigger bad guy, who are pawns of an even bigger bad guy, who are pawns for the biggest bad guy. Some of these bad guys are actually bad ladies, so I mean, not that that matters, but like, girls can be evil drug cartel murderers too, okay? It's 19. To acquire a mission, you need to grab intel folders that are scattered across the map, as each one grants you a mission to help chip away at the operation head in the area. It usually takes 4 to 5 missions to take out the bad guy in the area, so to say the least, you're going to be grinding these missions quite a bit. To get to these folders, you probably won't want to walk, as it's a rather large map. So instead, you're going to be using vehicles, and a lot of them. I'm sure Ubisoft knew this, which is why I question their decision to take the horrible driving mechanics in the other games and just lazily port it over to this game. Does copying and pasting save them money? Yes, but it doesn't feel good. When I'm pressing a key, I want to feel the vehicle moving with me. That's not how it works in this game. When you press a key, an animation of them turning happens, and they always overturn. It doesn't feel good. I will say, towards the end of the game, I started getting more used to the driving, as I typically do in Ubisoft games, but it's just frustrating that in a game that has such a focus on vehicles, they're not gonna bother to redesign the poor vehicle mechanics they've been using their entire game developing lives. It's lazy and it shows. Real talk. But where this game lacks in driving mechanics, it excels in the shooting mechanics. You can go from third person to aiming down the sights, and then you can swap shoulders and do the same thing. Which means no matter what, you're gonna be able to clear every corner in this game, and you feel so cool doing this. Just check this out. That is nice! Now, I like to structure my reviews like massage. I like to start off nice and easy, gently caressing them. And then I like to put some pressure into it, and more pressure into it, and grind my knuckles into the metal plate!
Why?
Ubisoft, what the heck are you guys doing, okay? Now I'm upset, alright? This is the upset section. I'm not happy with you guys. You guys have been making open worlds for such a long time, and yet you don't improve on the very basic and clear and screaming errors. The open world, Yes, it is a big world. Yes, the graphics look good, okay? I was really impressed by that. Yes, the character customization is good. But if what I put on my character doesn't really matter, that hurts me a little bit.
Talk.
I ain't no snitch, but I'll tell you this one thing.
What is the point of a massive world when there's nothing in it? The world doesn't reward you for exploring and going off-road, except for these stupid collectibles that do nothing. What's the point? All I'm doing is driving from mission to mission to mission to mission to mission. I played this game for 17 hours after 5 I was done. I just kept on playing because I wanted to make a review on it. Let me show you what an open world should look like, alright? Come on.
Okay, here's an example of an open world. What Ubisoft will do is they'll say, oh yeah, drive along this road, you can wave hi to that guy, hello, how's it going? Go over here, oh, what are you doing? You're picking from a tree, that looks amazing. Go along on the road, oh, look at that, a taco guy. Oh, the distance, it looks so cool, da 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 da. Ooh, and what's this way over here? Oh no, you can't go over there, that's a DLC. But how an open world should be is you should be able to interact with everything. Going along the road, see this guy, if he's waving at you, you should be able to wave back. You see this dude in the river over here, right? Maybe you can save him. You go over and you save him. He grants you a mission. Or maybe if you let him drown, this dude will be like, oh my, I hated him. I thank you forever. Then you go over here, this guy's picking stuff out of a tree. That means that you can do it too. You go over here, there's a taco man. You can buy stuff from the taco man. You look into the distance, you see a meteor. You can do something with the meteor. You go over here, oh, what's this in the distance? It's a secret military base that you found, which is a really cool side mission. It should be that you see things and you get excited because it's something you'll be able to do. Ubisoft either puts things behind paywalls or they make it pretty to look at. It's an open world. It's supposed to be interactable.
Once you play a few of Ubisoft's games, you start to realize they're all the same game. They just take the stuff they learned from the Far Cry series and they copy and paste it into the Tom Clancy series. Okay, this is an airsoft gun. Red means it's bad. Green means it's good. AI in the game. It's not bad. It's not exactly advanced, but it works. My favorite part of the AI in this game is that when you hop into a vehicle, you can drive away and they'll actually just be teleported in there with you. None of this realistic wait for your teammates to get into the vehicle baloney. I will say there was one time I was playing a stealth mission and my AI actually got detected and I failed the mission because of that. Granted, that only happened once. Which leads me into my next point. Forced stealth missions. They suck. What is by far the worst is this one mission I played. You would parachute into the base and that would be a checkpoint, right? Okay, not bad. You need to sneak aboard a helicopter after killing these dudes in the base without being detected. Not bad. You fly up in the helicopter, you gotta stay low, stay undetected. You get to all these rockets shooting at you, and mind you, you die in one rocket. You fly up and there's like 3 helicopters, okay? Your chances of living are incredibly hard. So you try to survive, you take out 2 of them, the 3rd one kills you. Then there's no checkpoint. You go all the way back to the military base to do the forced stealth part again. Stealth is fun, but not when you make me do it in this annoying way. Screw that. Gun diversity. Terrible. All the guns have pretty much the same stats, and once you get an assault rifle, then maybe a sniper rifle, you don't need anything else. Maybe bows, throwing knives, something more useful besides just using grenades the whole time would be really cool to see. But unfortunately, Ubisoft didn't do that. Ubisoft, the company themselves. I don't like them. Here you've got a concept, an idea that I really wanted to play, and yet you guys would rather go in for a quick cash grab. Biggest problem for Ubisoft, they care more about money than creating a quality game. If they create something in a game, in an open world, they're going to make sure you find it. Rockstar, for example. There'll be some stuff you will never find unless you go off-road, because that's the adventure of it, finding something new and crazy and enjoyable. Ubisoft and their desperation to keep on releasing and releasing and releasing titles with content locked behind paywalls is so old and frustrating, and I am just so sick of their money-hungry antics. I typically make more lighthearted videos. This one really wasn't, because I am sick of them doing this, and I really wanted this game to be good, and it sucks! Also, the ending. What the heck was that plot twist that you threw in? That was totally unnecessary. I didn't like it. And I got some bullets in this, so I'm just gonna spin the rest. Isn't that really cool in the gunlock spec? Anyways, my name's Nathan of Pretty Pink Unicorn. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, you can like it. If you didn't, that's fine.
As you could tell, I got a little bit frustrated there, so I forgot to give my rating. I give this game a 4 out of 10. It was fun to play, and I do enjoy the shooting, but that just doesn't make up for the lazy effort that is just so clear in the open world. You'll get sick of it pretty quickly like I did. My name's Nate of Pretty Pink Unicorn. Thank you for stopping by, and I hope to see you next time.